My name is Lisa, I'm 43 years old, and I have a horn on the back of my head. My growth started probably about a year ago. It grows every day, gets bigger, it's painful at times. It has a ring that it grows out of that is very tender. It's a horn. It's basically, you'd see a rhinoceros, it's a hard horn. I don't want anybody to see it, so I wear my hair up, pretty much tuck it under my hair. If I hit it, it hurts a lot. At work, we have racks, and I'll have to duck under them, so when I come back out, I, you know, have to make sure I don't hit my head on them, because it causes a lot of pain. The growth makes me feel gross. Who has, like, a horn growing out of their head? Jackson, you want to go play ball? Come on, Jax. Come on, Boo. I find myself being more reserved, not wanting to do things. Now I stay home a lot more than I used to.
Oh, I know. Ready?
When I'm spending time with my animals, I'm at peace because I know they're not gonna judge me.
Here, go over here.
They're not gonna see it, they're not gonna care.
So how was your day?
It was okay.
Yeah?
I have been engaged to my fiance for 5 years. He's been asking, you know, when are we gonna get married and set a date? And I put it off because I wanna, you know, look pretty on my wedding day. Usually when you get married, you're standing in front of everybody with your back to them. That's the first thing I think they're gonna see.
Are you gonna get that thing taken care of?
I'm gonna try.
Yeah?
I hope I can get it taken care of soon.
Don't worry about it. You're perfect no matter what, so.
Okay.
I think what's holding her back is just that she can't do her hair. I see embarrassment from her that she doesn't want to go out in public with her hair down. And
come on, Jax.
Come on.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how
I'm
are you?
Sandra. It's nice to meet you. What's going on? People don't come and see me and then start crying. Honey.
Just a lot of emotion.
Okay, all right. We're just here to talk right now and see what's going on with you, right? Can you tell me a little bit about it?
I have a horn growing out of my head.
Okay, all right. How long has that been going on?
A little over a year. My family suffers from, we get these other cysts on our head. I have a couple of small ones here. I have one right here.
Okay, yeah.
And then there's another one.
Okay.
And I had one and it broke. And of course I squeezed it.
Uh-huh.
It came to a point where I couldn't squeeze it anymore and then this started growing.
Okay. That's called a pilar cyst.
Well, my mother used to call them wens.
Yes, she's actually right. Wens, W-E-N.
Yes.
That is another term we use for those on your head.
Right.
A wen is just another term for a pilar cyst. Just like a mole is also called a nevus. Or a skin tag is also called an acrocordon. Or a wart is also called a verruca.
All right, shall I take a look at it? I'm very interested in seeing what this bump looks like now.
But the way that she describes her wen, it doesn't sound like any pilar cyst that I've seen before.
Yeah. It's like you have a fingernail that's gone crazy over here, huh?
Yes.
We call that usually a cutaneous horn when we see something like that.
That, like, ring around it is super sore.
And I can see how that's tender because it's really stretching your skin there. Let me take a little photo of it right now, actually, too.
I mean, I've seen cutaneous horns before. I mean, but certainly this is the largest cutaneous horn that I've ever seen.
Girl, we got to get rid of that thing for you.
Yes. Right? One of the things that I'm certainly thinking about with Lisa here is skin cancer, because one type of squamous cell carcinoma called a keratoacanthoma can look like this.
I'm not exactly sure what it is. I feel like you give me a story here that sounds like it could be a pilar cyst, and it has grown out of control. This is the angriest pilar cyst I've ever seen, if that's the case.
Right.
Because usually when we see a cutaneous horn, we do think of other things that might be a little bit more concerning, you know, that can happen with types of skin cancers.
I don't know whether it's benign. I don't know whether it's malignant. I'm hoping to figure out soon. I'm gonna try to excise this cutaneous horn. If something weird's going on underneath there, I might have to change my plan. We're gonna see.
All right, so you make sure we're not hurting you at all.
There's a little worry in the back of my mind that it could be cancerous.
I'm just gonna pull on this and see, okay? You guys ready? Yeah, one big swift knock from your dog, and I think you would have had this thing on the floor.
Gone.
I mean, it looks like pilar cyst contents underneath, but things can mimic that, so I'm just gonna try to take all that off. Just need to take that off. Now that's the skin we're gonna check to make sure there's no thing that we're like really concerned about.
Okay.
Sorry, a little tightness there. I am happy to tell you that it looks like we pulled together your skin very nicely there. Okay, you wanna see your little friend here?
I do.
You do. It's like almost like a mitten.
It's crazy.
So that, even if it was a skin cancer or a pilar cyst, this is all like wet skin cells. So as it's emerging out, it was drying up and getting hard like that.
Right.
Can you give me that metal top of that tray? Listen to this. So I'm gonna send that piece in, and I'm gonna send some of the regular skin too.
To see the horn that I've had on the back of my head for over a year sitting in front of me feels unreal, that it's finally gone. Don't know why I waited so long. I don't know why I just didn't do it before. I've missed out doing so many things the past year for something that took 30 minutes.
Oh, looking good. That's good. Right. So I need to have a serious talk with Lisa. These conversations can be challenging, but they're important.
So we took that off. It looks a lot like a pilar cyst, but the other thing that we really think about is squamous cell carcinoma, which is a type of skin cancer that can grow in this area, and it can have this cutaneous horn. That's what we tend to see. So
Okay. There's
a chance we might have to go on there and remove more just to make sure if there's a cancer there, okay?
All right.
It was so nice to meet you.
You.
I'm glad, and no more tears, so that's
Thank
good.
You. She said that it couldn't be a cancer. I'm anxious to come back to get my results. It's gone. Now it's, you know, we'll take the rest as it comes.
Hi, Lisa, how are you?
Good.
How was the bump on you? How was it recovery-wise? Was it okay?
It's fine.
That's the way I like to hear it. Okay, let me take a look at it, actually, first. Let's see how it's healing.
Looking at Lisa's scalp, it's healing so well. She's got hair growing where we excise that horn. But I know that what she's most interested in is finding out about her pathology results.
The area that I removed, we took two different portions of it and sent it in. The part that was like the horn.
Yep.
And then the part at the base. And the more important thing is that base part.
Okay.
Let me show you. Okay, so I have some nice pictures. That's actually the top of your skin. The dermatopathologist read your slide and they say it's an inflamed follicular cyst. There's no risk of cancer. I don't think it's ever coming back.
Hey.
Do you cry even when you get really happy
no,
about
I never
something?
Cry.
You don't?
No.
I only know you as a crier, though. How come?
I don't know.
Well, maybe it's a cry of relief, though, right? It is.
Yeah.
Let me give you some medical Kleenex. That's gauze to you, okay?